This is a Click-Fix pipe repair patch. This is made from copper and it actually has solder on the inside. So it's just like a solder ring fitting, but that will actually just clip onto the pipe and then you can solder that in position. Obviously you need to clean the pipe first. These are a fantastic idea if you get a hole in a copper pipe. It's very common for people to go around putting screws in the floorboards, trying to fix down loose boards. And sometimes people do puncture the pipes. If you do that, you get a screw in the pipe and the water leaks out. Obviously, this is just a on the bench demo, so I'm just going to demonstrate how these work. And then afterwards, I'm going to pressurize the pipe with some pressurized water and we'll see how much pressure one of these can actually take. So to start off with, I'm going to take a screw and we've got a copper pipe here. I'm now going to drive the screw into the copper pipe. If you did that in a real life situation, you would have water dripping out of the hole. So what you would have to do now is drain down the system or isolate the water and drain down to ensure there is no water in the pipe. Once you've done that, you can then remove the screw. If you take a look at that, we have got a bit of the copper sticking up where the screw has lifted it. So we do need to remove that first. We're going to do that using a file. Normally, if you were going to repair that, you would have to cut out a section of the pipe, possibly use a couple of slip couplings or a pipe repair coupling. But with this, you don't actually need to cut into the pipe. You can simply solder that over the top. So these are an absolutely fantastic idea. I actually paid £2.99 for that from Screwfix, and I've actually seen people selling these on eBay for £9. So please be careful where you buy them from, as there are some people out there that will take advantage of you. So before we can solder this on, we need to give that a clean. One of the best things for cleaning copper pipe before soldering is a Scotch-Brite pad. This is a piece that I've cut off. They are normally quite a bit larger than this. I've not actually seen these for sale previously, and it was actually a YouTube member that pointed me towards these. And I'm really sorry, I can't actually remember the name of the guy that recommended them. Now we've done that, I'm just going to apply a little bit of flux to the pipe. This will clean it even further. You can apply this with a flux brush if you have one. I'm now going to get the repair patch, ensuring that I've got it central. I'm going to push that directly over the hole. I'm now going to take some paper towel, I'm going to clean off any of the excess flux. Because we've got a piece of timber underneath, I'm just going to put this soldering mat underneath there like so. I'm then going to use the blowtorch, I'm going to apply some heat to the fitting and that will melt all the solder that is in there. You can see that we've got solder exiting from both of the ends, and if we turn it over, we've got solder along the long edges as well. So it does quite literally only take a couple of seconds for the solder to melt. I'm now going to use the pressure testing rig and we'll just see exactly how much pressure this can take. To start off with, I'm just going to remove any trapped air that's in the pipe because we don't want to pressurize the air. So we've now got water in the pipe. I'll now proceed to pressure test the pipe. So you can see that we're now at 10 bar. We're now at 20 bar. now at 30 bar. We're now at more than 40 bar. And we're now up past 50 bar, which is the actual limit of the pressure testing rig. And as you can see, there's no sign at all of that failing. So they are an absolutely fantastic idea for repairing copper pipes, because you don't actually need to cut the pipe to do the repair. That will give you a long lasting permanent repair. I hope you found this video useful. If you have and you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.